Now we will start with the section 1.1.2, and this section is vector algebra. Vector algebra, and it is on the component form. The component form of a vector. We know that when we consider space, then space is a three-dimensional space. Like we are having the x dimension, the y dimension, and the z dimension, like length, width, and height. So this I represent by x. This is x, this is y, and this is z axis. Now, I'm plotting three dimensions on a two-dimensional board. So that's why there will be, you can say, some tilt, and that tilt will just show a third dimension. Like if x and y is the plane of the board, then z axis is perpendicular to it. If y and z is the plane of the board, then x here is the perpendicular dimension to this one. So when I will consider this x and y, we call them x, y, and z axis, or we also call them x, y, and z bases. They are the bases of the vector space. Now, for these bases, I know that x unit vector is perpendicular to y unit vector and is perpendicular to z unit vector. They are just directions. Their magnitude is equal to 1. So they are perpendicular to each other. Then there are some calculations involved with them due to this perpendicularity. That if we take the dot product of any of these with them, like x dot x, y dot y, or z dot z, then this thing will be equal. This is a unit vector, so magnitude is 1 multiplied by magnitude 1, and the angle between them is 0, so this is equal to 1, and all will come out to be equal to 1. If we will take their dot product with any of the other axes, then this will be y dot z or z dot x. Then this will be always equal to 0, because there will be no contribution of one along the other. Similarly, when we come to the cross product, then x cross x is equal to y cross y and equals z cross z. And this will always be equal to 0, because we know that same vectors, if you sweep along the same vector, then there is no area swept, they are the same vectors. And another thing is that if I rotate one basis along the other, like x along y, so it will be equal to the third axis. It will be equal, x cross y will be equal to the z, because we will have their rotation, the cyclic rotation, x cross y equals z, and then the same will be true if I do y cross x, then it will be equal to minus times z unit vector. Y cross z will be equal to x unit vector, and similar the other will be true, and z cross x means the cyclic permutation, and z cross x will be equal to y vector. like we consider this is the plane, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. So if I rotate x along y, then it will be the z-axis. X along y, and then it will be the direction of this area will be z-axis. Y along x, and it will be minus z-axis, and so on. So this is for this three-dimensional space, which we also call vector space. Any vector, if I consider here, in this three-dimensional space, any vector, if I consider, let's say this is vector A. Now this vector A will have some projection on this plane of x and y. And let's say it is here. So this is the projection of this vector. Now this will have some contribution on this x-axis and some on y-axis. So this is x-axis and this is y-axis. We have, this is the x component. So this is the x component, this is the y component, and this is the y component. So I write y and x with it. So this will be a y and this will be a x. Similarly, this will have a component on the z axis as well. And this I will call is the a z component. So it will have three dimensions. Vector A, I can write that this is AX and the X unit vector plus AY and the Y unit vector and AZ and the Z unit vector direction. This sometime we write the X, Y and Z, the X, Y and Z basis is I, J, K as well. So this is also one way of representation to write them as AX and I, AY and J and AZ and K. In some books you may see the bases like EX, EY and EZ. So they are just different representation. Some may have E1, E2 and E3. This, some books may write A1 and X, A2 and Y and AZ and Z axis. So these are just the representations. And similarly, if we are having another vector, which is vector B, so vector B will also be having these three dimensions, like the B, the vector B, B, X dimension and X. Okay, I will not write vector symbol here, it's the component, plus B, Y and Y and B, Z and Z. Any vector I can write in its component form in three-dimensional vector space is like this. When I will be adding them, like vector A plus vector B, now their respective components will be added. So this will be equal to AX plus BX and the X unit vector plus AY plus BY and the Y unit vector and AZ plus BZ and the Z unit vector. And I can write them in a compact form as AI, BI, and this will be the I unit vector, and then it will be a summation, and summation, there will be a plus symbol here, and summation on I such that I runs from 1 to 3. Like 1 is for X, 2 is for Y, and 3 is for Z axis. If I multiply them with any constant, then these are just numbers. They are constant and they are numbers, so it will be multiplied with that. And if I write them in the form of dot product, A dot B, then their inner components, means their same components, will be multiplied, and it will be equal to AX, means I will write A then dot B, so it will be AX dot BX first, means they are the magnitudes, so there will be no dot here, but AX and BX, the magnitudes will multiply as they are just number, and the dot product is between X dot X. Similarly, plus there will be AX which will be multiplied with BY, so it will be AX and BY, but X dot Y, and X dot Y from here I know that it is equal to 0, and due to that reason the two other components will become 0. The only components that will survive will be the like, are the inner components like AY, BY, and plus this will be Y dot Y. Y dot Y will become 1 from here, and AZ and BZ. So the A dot B, that's why we call it an inner product, that only the inner components are being multiplied here, while the rest will not survive, they will go to 0. So AY, BY plus AZ and BZ. Similarly, if we are having 3-4 vectors, then it will be the same thing. If I consider this vector A, and then if I find A dot A, then it will be equal A dot A, means the scalar product with itself. So it will be AX multiplied with AX X dot X. So it will be equal to AX squared plus AY squared plus AZ squared. So A dot A will be equal to the square of these components, and this is equal A dot A from A cos of the angle between the two is equal to A squared, because cos of theta is equal to 0, is equal to AX squared plus AY squared plus AZ squared, and this is equal to, this implies that vector A, if I take the square root of both sides, then this is equal to AX squared plus AY squared plus AZ squared and square root. So this will give me the magnitude of A. I can write it like this, or simply is A equal to this one. If I want to find any component of it, like I am interested to find the X component of a vector, then I will multiply X unit vector dot vector A, and it will give me its component, which is AX. Similarly, Y dot A vector will give us the Y component of this vector, and the Z dot A will give us the Z component of this vector. And this way we will be able to do the things in component form. Similarly, we can calculate the cross product, and the cross product will be, means when the same two vectors are, means A cross B, are being multiplied as a cross product, then there is a way to do this thing easily, and that is the x unit vector and the y unit vector and the z unit vector we will write in one row. First, we will write the components of Ax along these, the components of A, then the components of B in another row, and we will then multiply them. So they can be very easily multiplied. I know that when I want to calculate the x, then I will have to eliminate this row and this column. So it will be the non-x one here. It will be equal to AYBZ minus AYBZ minus AZBY. And this is equal to, this is the x unit vector. Similarly, when I go to the next row, then it will be minus automatically. And then I will delete the row in the column, so it will be the non-y components. So it is ax and bz minus az and bx, and it will be along y. Similarly, the other component will come in, and that will be the plus, so it will be the z component. It is axby, axby minus aybx, and it will be along the z unit vector. If I want to write them in compact form, and later on we will do this thing with the help of Kronecker delta and Levi-Civita tensor, we will do them, but we can write them. If I look here, then this thing I can write in compact form is I running from 1 to 3, and this will be AIBI. Because when I is 1, then it will be A1B1 or AXBX plus A2B2 or AYBY, A3B3 or AZBZ, and it will stop. If I want to write this one in component form, then I can look here. When it is the X component, so the X component will be the non-X component of the vectors, like AYBZ minus AZBY and X, and this A cross AX and BZ, and this will be the Y component and so on. But we will write this thing in the form of Levi-Civita tensor, and in that form it is easy to understand the cross product here. So we will do that thing in the Levi-Civita tensor, which we will cover in the coming lectures.